So in this video, we're going to talk about the surfaces option in IQmol. So right now, there's nothing really here, but if I double click on it, it brings up a window that gives me the option to add surface. And generally, we're going to be looking at the van der Waals surface, which is basically spherical distance around the atoms, which comes from van der Waals radius for individual atoms. You also have options for generating surfaces of promolecules and SID, which are used in specific other cases, so for certain types of atoms or for ions. So general purpose, you will be using van der Waals, and you can adjust the scale, how big it is, and the quality, but generally the defaults are fine. So I'm going to go ahead and calculate this surface. And when I do that, you can see that I get basically spheres that form around each of my atoms. So far, all I've done is generate a distance. Now if I go over to the surfaces tab, there's a little arrow, so I can expand that. And it shows that the van der Waals surface here is highlighted. If I double click on that van der Waals surface, I now have some additional options. So I can color the surface based on the properties. So originally we have none selected. I can also look at things like the radial distance, so how far away it is from the center of mass. At the center, it's red. As you move out from the center, it becomes blue. I could also look at the nuclei, which is basically just the colors of the atoms. And the most useful one is really this ESP, or electrostatic potential surface. So if I select that, what this is actually showing me is the difference in charge of the different areas of the molecule. So this is similar to what you get from a dipole moment, but now showing which areas of the molecule have extra charge. So the red indicates there's extra electrons, it's the negative part of the surface, and the blue indicates you have a lack of electrons, and it's the positive part of the surface. So this lets you look at a molecule and determine if it's polar overall or not. Again, this is similar information to what's provided from looking at the dipole moment. Under the display menu, you have options for atom labels, and partial charges can give you a numerical value associated with that charge separation, so that can be useful. You can also label by other things like the element name, the mass, the index, basically what order it's implemented in.